friends, welcome to Databricks video tutorials. And today's session I am going to cover on notebooks. So previous sessions have covered on theoretical things and how to create a community edition for practicing and how to create a cluster. And this session I am going to cover on notebooks. So how to create a notebook and how to use notebooks and what are the features and what are the options available in Databricks notebooks. So how to create a notebook means there is a workspace here, and there are two ways we can create a notebook here. One is you can go to share folder and create any folder. So normally in any of the project, if multiple people are working, what we will do, we will create a folder that's a development or module name, whatever it is. Then the multiple people can share this folder and they can create a notebooks here. And if anything user specific, for example, I have a user specific, what I can do, I can go to the user, select your user and create a new folder, or for training, there you can create a notebook. Okay, so you can click on this folder, then there is an option called create notebook. Okay, this is one method where we can create a notebook. So if whatever you are created, it will be there inside your user folder. If you create a share folder, there multiple people can access that notebook. So just start with creating a notebook. So while creating a notebook, the three options you will get: name, default language, you can choose the language, and cluster. So here the name, user defined name, any name you can use this. PySpark. Then language. So Databricks, we can use four languages: Python, Scala, SQL and R. So default we are going with Python. So this tutorial I will give you overview on Python. So just start with the Python and later we'll learn SQL also. Okay, just create using Python. So my notebook has been created, and if you have any cluster, default you can see this cluster is attached here. So what is attached and reattach? So if you go to clusters, there you can find the clusters. This is a community edition where we will get a 15 GB memory free cluster. There we will get only master node, that header node we will get, worker node we won't get here. And this is part of complete cluster related. If you go to enterprise edition, there you will get multiple options, cluster type and other things, but here we don't see any cluster type. So because it's a training purpose we are using this, that's why you can see community edition, it's optimized for here, they are giving for 15 GB and 2 crore, that is only header node you will be getting the driver type. Let's start with the notebooks, my PySpark. So look at the features, what are the features it is available. Let's look at here. Attach and detach. Okay, so if you want to run any command here, that command will be executed into this cluster. So that means I have selected this runbook, it will be wherever I am, whenever I am running this commands, it will be executed into this cluster. That is called attach. Detach means, see, this notebook does not have an initial any cluster. So detach and I reattached. Okay, detach means completely removing. Removing means only from this notebook I'm detached from that cluster. Okay, that's called detached. So whenever if you are running this, for example, I'm creating one variable, while running it will ask the attach to some cluster. Okay, attach and run. So attach and run means we need some cluster to run this any Python code or any SQL or anything. For that you can attach again, select this one. Okay, you can select here, or while running it will ask the attach. So there is a runway, you can use this run cell option, click on this. So it is running now, it is executed. And if you want to print the values again, you can use this control enter default shortcut, we can use this. Then this is called attaching and detaching whatever you have a notebook to your cluster. Okay, this are related. And restarting a cluster, and if you want to restart this cluster, you can restart this cluster. That's another option. You can see this, and directly you can go to Spark UI and driver logs. You can go, instead of going here, directly you can click on this. It will route to checking the logs and other things. And there are other options here. You should know about this. This is related to your notebook related. If you want to clone this notebook, you want to create another notebook, existing complete code, you can clone and create a new notebook. And creating a new notebook, renaming current notebook, and moving a notebook from one place to another place. Just clone this notebook. See here, you can give a new name. Just I am giving a clone in this training folder. Okay. See, it is create a new notebook with the same commands, whatever I have existing notebook it is there. So after that, you need to attach this if you want to run this. That's called a clone. A rename, if you want to rename, you can use rename this notebook name. Just I'm giving some name. See, it is renamed here. If you click also here, you can rename. Double click there and you can rename. So multiple ways you can rename, and the complete path you can see here. This is a complete your notebook path where it is available in the user folder, training folder. There you can see this notebook, and the type, this notebook type is, language type is Python, and directly you can run any Python code. If you want to run other than Python code, what we can do, we can use percentage. If you want to run SQL, you can use percentage SQL, then run any other commands. So SQL related, there is a data here. There is a databases here. You can create any database and you can create a tables and you can load the data. That any SQL commands you can run here. Create database test. Okay. Just control enter. See, SQL query also executed because we are using percentage SQL. So in this notebook, you can run any language. If you save Python also, you can run any language. But that language, you need to, whenever you are running that language, you need to specify percentage. If you are running SQL, percentage SQL. If you are running a Scala, percentage Scala. Same thing, if you want to run R, you can specify R like this. Like this, we can go for running any other language code, like multiple commands we can run, multiple languages we can run in notebook. This is the basic thing we should know. Then other thing, moving, export, publish. This is all related to your notebook. Moving from any, if you have other folders, if you want to move this, you can. So I am coming, so I want to move out of this folder. Just you can go to workspace. Here you can see it is out. This file is moved from training folder to outside training folder. Like that, we can use a move option. Delete, if you want to delete this, it will get deleted. Export, there are multiple options are available. Export source file, default whatever source file is there, it will be exported as a source file. And IPython, this is only for Python. So this option you will get if you save this file as a Python, you will get IPython that you can open. Okay, in, and there is another one called DBC archive file and HTML. So HTML is completely HTML format file, it will be downloaded. Let's start with the source file. You can see this source file, you can open and you can see this because it will create as a .py file, and whatever data is there, you can see that. See here, complete commands will be there. It's a, we opened with the Notepad++, that's why it is showing as a complete here. If you know, open in Notepad++, there it will show clearly. Then other options you cannot open here, like if you export DBC file, here you can see .dbc. Same thing, if you export as IPython, IPython also you cannot open in, you can open but you cannot see that whatever data is there because it's a raw file. See, if you open notebook, see, same thing for IPython, there also complete JSON data. See this one. So same thing, if you open HTML also, it will export as a complete HTML file. See here HTML. So this is multiple types of backups you can create. Same thing, you can export multiple types of files and publish. So publishing this notebook, okay. So if you have any existing notebook already, so it will overwrite. That's called publish. See here, this is the link where this is the publish link. This link you can use that. Okay, this notebook was successfully published. Then you can, this URL you can use wherever you want this. Okay, this is a complete URL. Okay, that's called a publish. So wherever outside this network, if you want to use this notebook, you can use that. Okay, that is called a publish. And clear revision history. So revision history is whenever you are doing some changes, there is an option called a comment also here. If you are working any of the project, your team lead, they want to review this code, they can review this code and mention the comment. That's called, this is a comment section is available. Okay, this multiple options for reviewing your code, and they can mention the comments like they don't like, or maybe they are suggesting few changes, so they can mention in this. This is called a commenting. You can click on this. Then other options is individual cells related and replacing. Delete cell, cut cell, copy cell. So this cell, if you want to delete, that cell is deleted. So current position, same thing like this. Cut cells. Okay, if it is cut, again there is an option again, a paste cell below, above, you can see this options. Yeah, this is okay. This is called related to cells related. And find and replace, there is any program code change, if you want to do that and you want to replace some table name to x to y, so what you can do, find x and replace to y. It's like this. If you click on replace, see wherever a is there, it will replace b. See a here and here is there, it is, the response is very slow. This called a finding and a replace. So my system response is very slow, the browser, so that's why it is taking longer time. So like this we can go for using find replace, this option. Okay, then and other options, major thing is here, if you want to display here, hide row numbers, hide like line numbers and command numbers. This is a command number and this is line numbers. If you want to hide command numbers, see command 1, command 2 is hided now. Show command numbers, same thing, hide or show line numbers. See line numbers is hided now. These are all the options. And show results only. Instead of, if you don't want to show code, it will show only results only. So code means it will show both. Okay, and there is other option, running entire notebook. This option is called, if you run this, entire notebook will be executed. And this is failed because table already exists. Okay, and this is a major option, which is clear result, clear state. Results means here, and state is very important. Whenever you are running multiple commands, what will happen? So I will show you one notebook which will have a multiple commands. This is a quick start note. So in notebook, that execution approach is top down approach. So whenever, if you run this all here, you can, there is an option called, so all commands will be executed. You can see fifth command is running now. You can see this. So if fifth command is running, other commands are, you can see this, waiting to run. So waiting to run, sometimes what will happen, if cluster is not responding properly, those will be still show that longer time waiting to run. That time what you can do, clear state. Clear state means whatever is state are there, those will be cleared. So clear state, see now it's cleared. Actually it is waiting to run remaining all, but we cleared that. That's called whenever normally this will come, multiple people are working and the cluster capacity is very low, and if you are working on huge data processing and if you run this entire notebook and a few commands, still it will say run, waiting to run, maybe due to some cluster issues. That time what you can do, clear state. After that, clear state and results. Results means just run it again. I will show you where it will store the results. This OK is nothing but a result. Whatever you are running SQL queries, this also a result. So clear results, it will clear the results. Clear state, it will clear the, cancel the whatever waiting state and other things. Both clear state and clear results, both will cancel this. And clear state and run all. Sometimes it will stuck, maybe due to some cluster issues. What we'll do, you can do, instead of restarting this clusters, sometimes we will do restart cluster. Instead of restarting cluster, first time we can do just clear state and run all. Okay, again it will clear the current state and it will restart. So currently it is running. Okay, so you can click on cancel. If anything is running, you can click on cancel. See, so currently it is running right here. It is running. If you cancel this, click on this, it will be suspended. Now you can see it is suspended. See here, cancelled, and the remaining commands, it is showing that command skipped. So clear state and results, so both will be removed. Okay, now you can go for running this. Click on run, again it will start from all the commands, and remaining commands it will show as waiting, you can see. So waiting to run, see all commands. Current command 7th is running. See here, yeah, 7th is running. This is Python code, so that's why it is saved as a SQL. So we can run Python code using %Python, and it is creating one data frame based on existing data file which is available in our Databricks. Okay, then we are creating an external file that's called saving into pocket file. This is overwrite we are using option, and the remaining commands you can see it is waiting state. So this is called complete related to notebook information. These are all the options, and other options as I shown here. This one you can use for comments. If you want to comment here, that comment section you can use that. And these all are notes where %MD if you specify, it will treat as a comment section. It will like, it will ignore this. Okay, these are all notes. So you can specify notes using %EMD. So later other sessions we will learn this. Then as I told, if you want to specify any comments, so here you will get a comment sometimes. So here, see this. So you can specify this section is a comment section or note or manual. Okay, comment. See, this comment is available. Whichever I have commented, it is there. Again, someone can reply on this comment. For example, if you are working some project and your lead reviewed your code and he commented few changes, he suggested few changes, you can do those changes and you can respond that saying that I have done these changes. And those will be recorded here. So this is called a comment section. Okay, so these are multiple commands we can run. So another session we will start with examples. How to use these notebooks. These are our basic things which you should know before starting your notebook. Okay, so if you like this video, please subscribe my channel and share this video. Thank you for watching my videos. Thank you very much.